Let's talk more on the MBS report. Joining us is Channel's business editor, Bosin Omofaye. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Melinda.
Bosin, let's look at this report. I know there's no country that doesn't have some form of corruption, but looking at the numbers, 400 billion naira in 1 year alone, is this mind-boggling?
Yes, it's a little bit mind-boggling. It's a little bit above 1 billion US dollars and a little about 1% of Nigeria's GDP. But that's the actual money paid in bribes to government officials. But if you look at the knock-on effect of 400 billion naira, if you look at the time wasted, if you look at the time it takes you to pay the bribe or complete the process of giving bribe, for example, if the police stops you on the way, or perhaps more important, if you're shipping goods out of Nigeria or you're importing and you are delayed for an hour, for 2 days, perhaps for a week, to provide some form of bribes to customs officials, well, perhaps you're paying a bribe of 10,000 naira, but it has cost you a week to come up with 10,000 naira or 100,000 or perhaps a million naira, whatever the case may be. But if you look at the knock-on effect of these goods not getting to the market, the knock-on effect on your profit, your revenue, and perhaps you've taken a bank loan to do the import or the export. Now, if you look at the knock-on effect on the economy and social welfare, on wealth creation and disposable income of Nigerians, what comes to you and jobs creation is far more than 400 billion. We'll be talking about trillions and trillions of naira, hundreds of billions in US dollars. So it's as bad and it's as perversive as that. So don't let us just look at 400 billion as the amount for a year. If you look at the entire gamut, what we're losing as a country is far more. Lives are also being lost because of bribes. Because vehicles that are supposed to be expected are not cleared for as being roadworthy are on the roads, and because of bribe and corruption, or bribery and corruption, this costs, this explodes on the way, there are accidents, lives are lost. So what we're losing as a country is far more than what this report is just scratching the surface.
But those are supposed to help us, you know, make sure that these monies don't go anywhere, like the judiciary, the courts, for instance, which just asked a permanent secretary like Mr. Onubogu to forfeit all these buildings and monies he acquired over time. Who's supposed to help to put this everything in order? If so, people like the police is the highest, followed by the judiciary before the customs. But I'm looking at the police and the judiciary now.
I think there's a bit of what is changing since 1999 under the civilian democracy dispensation. We've seen a little bit of more what you call civil activists, society organizations who are ramping up on government should declare their budget. MDAs should also disclose their budgets. State government should disclose their budget. They should disclose their expenditure. There should be more transparency and accountability in government reporting. There should be more corporate governance issues in public service institutions. All these are going to take some time, but as the public sector and the private sector, the civil society groups and the media continue to put pressure on government and government officials and government agencies and those who do business with the government, you find out that this will begin to come into the surface. The most important thing is that we have a report that is comprehensive, that is holistic about how we are in Nigeria, where we are as far as bribery and corruption. Even the media has its title sector in this particular report. So it's everybody down the line. But as we all begin to ramp up and say in our own little space to ask for disclosure, ask for transparency, ask for accountability at various levels, there will be further opportunities for us to engage the government officials and begin to rein in what you call corrupt practices. Now, every government agency that you've just talked about, the judiciary, the prosecution, the law, whatever, everybody now knows that, look, my sector, my name is out there in the open. So what do we do about it? Perhaps the IG is talking to his men. Perhaps the Comptroller General is talking to the customs officers as now and say, look, we are number two or we're number three. The National Judiciary Council, they're sitting together and say, look, our names are also there as prominent among those who are most corrupt in Nigeria. What are we going to do about this image? And they should also come to the National Economic Council, the presidency, the executive branch of the government, and the National Assembly to say, look, we need to do something about it. This is really bad. This is full disclosure. We've opened our books. We've reported on where we are. But how do we resolve this and cut it back and begin to get better?
Bosin Omofaye, our business editor, thank you for coming on the program.
Thank you.